Thank you, Mr. President. On behalf of Aziza and the delegation, I must express my profound thanks and gratitude for the warm welcome. And I believe and concur what you have expressed, the need to not only to reaffirm our commitment to work together, but to enhance Malaysia-Philippine relations. Guided by shared interests, multinational, multidimensional bilateral cooperation, and vibrant people-to-people interaction. President Marcos Jr., let me assure you that the new administration in Malaysia will be more than happy to further enhance this collaboration. Our bilateral cooperation is multi-sectoral, covering trade and investment, education, health, agriculture, health, tourism, and culture. And I have alluded to earlier how our first generation of Malaysian professionals benefited immensely from the work at Los Baños and some of the known centers of learning in the Philippines. Our defense and security ties are also strong and growing. We share common borders and to an extent quite porous. Therefore, the collaboration needs to be further enhanced. We agreed to resume the 8th Joint Commission meeting to be led by both foreign ministers this year at a mutually convenient date. It's our turn to host this meeting, and I have advised the colleagues in the Foreign Ministry to facilitate and accelerate this process. We also discussed areas for further collaboration. New and important sectors such as halal industry, food security, which you have placed so much importance and have actually taken impressive strides in this direction. Digital economy and are among the key areas that I propose as potential cooperation. The President and I also agreed that both countries should intensify efforts to increase the volume of trade and investments. We have had a good beginning, but there's no excuse why we can't further increase the both trade and investment that would be of tremendous benefit to both our countries. We also agreed that we should deepen the existing strong people-to-people ties through closer cultural and tourism collaboration, education, and sports. Malaysia stands ready to explore potential new collaboration with the Philippines in this regard. Now, the peace process in Mindanao. I must express again my profound thanks and gratitude. This has been a century-long contentious issues that invariably affect the region and in particular Malaysia too. And under your leadership, President, you have seen great strides in this direction. And I think it is only our duty as a good neighbor to support and facilitate the process. And I stand guided, whatever things need to be done at the bilateral, multilateral level to support this endeavor. It has to succeed in the interests of the Philippines and Malaysia and the region. And then utilize this enormous potential to the benefit of our people. Malaysia will also continue to offer assistance to the Bangsa Moro people through various capacity building programs, including through our Malaysia Technical Cooperation Program. In my meeting with the President, I've asked the Philippines' assistance and cooperation to expedite the documentation of nationals so that they can be repatriated to the Philippines in a timely manner. And I am pleased that the willingness to facilitate this arrangement in a mutually agreed fashion. We also reiterated our commitment to continue supporting and enhancing cooperation with the BIMMP, IAGA, including hosting the Brunei, Indonesia, Malaysia, Philippines Facilitation Center. I did express my concern about the contentious, unresolved Myanmar issue, which is affecting Malaysia adversely due to the huge number of refugees, exceeding 200,000 people now in Malaysia. The President, in his wisdom, has reiterated the need for the five-point consensus, but I would certainly suggest, with his experience and wisdom, to explore new areas, how the Myanmar junta can be persuaded to work and collaborate as a team within ASEAN and resolve the outstanding issues which cannot be considered as purely internal, because it's affecting the security and welfare of the region. We did discuss the South China Sea issue, and I shared President Marcos Jr.'s concern that due to the complexity and sensitivity of the issue, we should try and engage and take the position at the multilateral level between ASEAN, so that we have a comprehensive approach and achieve an amicable resolution to this outstanding problem. Maraming salamat po, Mr. President. I am extremely pleased. I must reiterate again that I was first here in Malacanang Palace when President Marcos was the president as a young Minister of Agriculture, and how pleased I am to be back here with Marcos Jr. Kambombong to be there. And thank you very much for this hospitality, and I'm of course deeply touched by your kind words and support.